Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this MailerLite tutorial, you're going to learn everything you need to know to get up and running, growing your email list with MailerLite. We're going to go through the basic settings in MailerLite, setting up your first autoresponder, and of course, putting together your landing page so you can actually start driving traffic to your email list. Timestamp table of contents in the description, along with some other helpful videos to generating leads and being successful with your email marketing. So with that, let's go ahead, jump right in. So the first thing you want to do is, of course, go to MailerLite.com and set up your free account. They give you 500 to 1,000 subscribers for free. You can check out our affiliate link in the description. And once you've set up your free account, it might take a couple days to be activated. You're going to want to come into your dashboard. You probably have zero subscribers to start, but we're going to change that by creating our landing page. So we're going to go ahead and click on site. Something that's really awesome about MailerLite is you don't have to worry about creating your landing pages or dealing with other page builders. You can actually grow your email list 100% using MailerLite. And in this particular video, we're going to be going through an example of building a landing page that looks like this, or this simple layout. Now, these landing pages aren't going to win a design award by any means, but they work. And most importantly, you can get up and running really, really quickly. So let's go ahead and build our landing page. I'm actually going to build a second version of this analytics checklist so you can see how fast it is to actually put together your landing page. So we'll click on create landing page. We'll go ahead and give our landing page a name, something nice and clear that we're going to remember in the future, because hopefully you're going to be making several of these landing pages. Next, MailerLite is going to ask you what group you want your new subscribers to be added to. So typically you're going to want to have two groups. One group is going to be everyone who has ever opted into a landing page. That's going to be your entire list. And then the second one is going to be based upon the lead magnet or landing page that they've specifically opted into. So in this particular instance, we would click on One Aspire Entrepreneur. That would be everyone. And then because I'm doing this for the first time, I can click on add new group and create a group specifically for people who are entering their name and email to get this lead magnet on this landing page. So we'll go ahead and click on create. And now we have our two groups. We'll go through automation. So you'll see that emails will automatically go out when they are added to our specific group, not when they're added to everyone, the everyone group. So we'll go ahead and click on save and continue. And now we get to choose the template. They do have quite a few options here. They all look really nice, but we're going to 80/20 this process and start from scratch, because we don't need our template to win any design awards. We don't need our landing page to be the greatest looking. We just need it out there and, most importantly, done. So I'm just going to go ahead and select the first one. You can pretty much select any one of these because we're going to just remove everything. I do recommend, though, making sure you select one that doesn't have a top navigation. So we'll go ahead and select this one, and then we will just start from scratch. And there's going to be two ways we can do this. Number one, we can go and manually delete one by one each one of these elements, or we can come up to actions and remove content blocks. Just start with a blank slate. Type in remove to let them know, yes, we really do want to start from scratch. And now we have a completely blank landing page. But don't worry, we only need a couple of elements. So we're going to start off with a headline. If it will actually go on, come on. Sometimes the first element, there we go. All right, so we've got our headline. First element takes a while. Then we're going to go down to our forms, and we want a sign up form with a image, and we'll go ahead and drop that underneath our headline. And then depending upon your niche and legal things, this is not legal advice at all, you're probably going to want some sort of disclaimer text at the bottom of your page. And so these are really the only three elements that you need. I'm going to leave the disclaimer text alone, and we're going to go ahead and click up here and start with the headline. Something nice and simple. If you want more information on how to do the actual copywriting for your landing page, I'll link up in the description to a full-blown tutorial that goes through landing page copywriting. I'm going to make it medium and make sure that it's in the center. You can always come in here and change the colors and the fonts and the size. Since we're talking about Google Analytics and it's orange, I'll go ahead and change the font and color a little bit and make sure that this is centered. And so wide, medium, and narrow. You want to make sure that you do use these options to change how your text looks, because this is going to be responsive. So if you start putting spaces randomly places, it's not gonna look good when it translates to mobile. I'll just add a little more space at the top here because there's not going to be so much on the page. And I think that's good enough for our checklist. So the next thing we need is we need an image for our actual offer that we're making, a couple of bullet points as to why they should enter their name and email, and of course, their actual name and email. So we'll start with the image. I already have one uploaded ready to go. I use Canva for pretty much all of our lead magnets. So I've just exported the cover of our PDF that we're offering from Canva. And you can check out a link in the description on how to put that together. And this is literally all I did for the lead magnet, a text, one big picture. This picture cost $1 from Canva. And then all of the information that someone is looking for when they get the analytics checklist. And I also have a call to action at the end for them to actually book a sales call with us. So more about lead magnets and how to put them together with Canva, all that fun stuff linked up in the description. So we have our lead magnet image here and we can actually click on edit image. So if you need to make some minor adjustments, keyword minor, this editor has you covered. I'm okay with the size. I'm actually going to use something else to mess with the size in a little bit here. So for our headline here, we're just going to put if I can do it without capitalizing two letters, you're going to get dot, dot, dot. And then we're going to want 3 to 5 bullet points. Now, this is one of the areas where I really wish MailerLite actually had a bullet point block, but don't worry, in the description, I will link up this little line of text that will allow you to use the checkmark emoji to create your bullet points. So all you need to do is click on HTML, we'll delete all of this, and then we'll paste this in. And now we have bullet 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, link in the description to copy paste this. This is as close to HTML as you have to get. And all we need to do to change our bullets is just highlight bullet and then the number, and we can say what we need to about our specific offer. And speeding ahead, we have our couple of bullet points. You're definitely going to want to spend a significant amount of more time. I'll link up again in the description to that video that goes through how to actually write bullet points for your landing page. So now the only other thing we need to do is change the button text and the button color to either match or stand out from everything else on the page. Now right now, red, that pretty much stands out here. So I can actually leave that alone, but I'll show you how to change this. We're going to change this to download now, and then we'll click on form and we will add a field. We're going to want their name, and I'm going to put their name on top there so we get their name and their email. You don't have to ask for the name. We just find that it's a lot more, it gives you a lot more flexibility in your email marketing if you actually have their name. So then we can come over here to settings. This is where we can start playing with how this looks. So for example, we can come down here and change the form to checklist ratio. So we can make the image bigger, we can make the form bigger, we can keep them equal. I actually kind of like the way this looks. So we'll go ahead and leave it alone. We can of course switch the alignment and then squeeze things in or even squeeze them in even more. Now, if you're worried about mobile, that's not really necessary. It's going to format on mobile automatically for you. So we'll just go ahead and leave it on wide, I think is the best way to go. And if you scroll down here, you can change your call to action button, the color, and then you can also change the hover color. So if I wanted to come over here and make the hover color dark orange, now when you hover over it, it's dark orange. Versus something like green means go, right? So now we'll go ahead and click. Now it'll be download now when someone goes to click on it. And that will, and then of course you have your font styles, colors, and you can also make it full width. Here we go. You can also make it full width as well. So I'm just going to leave it nice and small in the center and then make the text way bigger so the button is larger and much more apparent. So again, you can play with this all day long, but right now, as you can see, we've put together a landing page that's actually going to work in less than 10 minutes. It's pretty awesome. So we'll go ahead and click on save here. And if we go into preview mode, you'll actually be able to see what it would look like on desktop and then more importantly, what it will look like on mobile. So here is our desktop preview, and then we can click over here to mobile, and you'll see that it does a very good job of formatting everything for mobile. The other advantage too is because you're not being fancy, you're pretty much guaranteed to have this style work on any screen size, any mobile device. So we'll go ahead and exit out of our preview, and we are complete with our landing page. I hope you can see how easy and simple that was. So we'll go ahead and click on save and publish, and we'll quickly go through some advanced settings before we dive into our actual email sequence setup. So when it comes to your page settings, if you decide to pay an extra $10 a month, which I totally think it's worth it, you can come down here and actually create your own, use your own domains, which I think is very important, especially if you're doing Google Analytics tracking, which you should. I'll link in the description to that. And then we can go ahead and change what our domain will actually be. I'll just call it the analytics checklist. Now, when it comes to favicons, please, please, please take the 10 minutes to create your own favicon. So if we come up here, you can see that the MailerLite favicon is this little green box, right? So you don't want that little green box on your landing pages. You want your own logo. So you can either do 16 by 32, I think also 50, let me go ahead and choose an image here so I remember the dimensions. 55 by 35 is the best way to go. So I'll just go ahead and select that. And now our actual company logo is going to show up when someone hits our landing page as opposed to MailerLite's. It's just a little extra step to add some professionality to your, I don't think that's a word, but add some professionalism to your landing pages. SEO, when it comes to landing pages, you don't want them indexed. If you are going to be doing any sort of paid traffic, really anything at all with paid traffic, you need to have your Google Analytics, Facebook Pixel, your Google Ads remarketing tag. I have a full-blown tutorial on how to use something called Google Tag Manager to get all of these tags right in your landing page, a very easy and almost code-free way. So you can check out the link in the description for the Tag Manager course. And with that, those are all the settings you really need to worry about. So we'll go ahead and click on save and continue. And now our page is live. So let's go check out the live preview. This is what our page looks like. Because we updated the favicon, you can see it says ACT in very, very tiny letters as opposed to the MailerLite logo. And now people can enter their name and email and they'll be able to get the analytics checklist. Well, almost, right? Because we need to make sure that some emails go out when someone actually fills out this form. So let's go ahead and go back to our dashboard here, and we're going to click on automation this time. So now it's time to set up that email sequence that goes out once they enter their name and email. This is very important, even if you only have one email going out. That's better than nothing. So we'll come up here and click on create workflow, and then we're going to name this workflow after our offer or landing page. And the reason I use the same names across everything is it just makes it a whole lot simpler to keep track of what's going on inside of your account. So here we go, we can set up a workflow trigger. Now, this is where it can get a little tricky. So we can either say when someone joins a list, or we can say when someone enters their name and email on a specific landing page. In this particular instance, I like using lists because you might have multiple landing pages for the same lead magnet. So you'll have multiple landing pages, but at the end of the day, you only want one email sequence because you're giving the same thing away. So we'll go ahead and use joins a subscriber group, and we'll be able to select the group that we just created. Repeat workflow for subscribers who rejoin the same group. I typically just leave this off. If someone enters their name and email again for whatever reason, I don't want to send them the same sequence over again. So we'll go ahead and click on save, and then we can set up our first trigger. So our first trigger is actually going to be an email. So this email is going to be the link to whatever you're giving away for free. Go ahead and give our email a subject. We can go ahead and play with emojis. You can also insert things that you collected. So if we wanted to put their name, we could say, hey, exclusively for, or hey, name, here's your checklist, something to that effect. And then when we click on design email, we'll actually be able to put in the text of the email that we're going to be sending. And I really like to keep things simple and just use the rich text editor. When it comes to email deliverability, typically most of the service providers look at emails that have a lot of pictures or look really pretty in their design as something that's marketing. So you're much more likely to get through if you just start off with a normal text email like this one. So we could just put in all of our text.
One eternity later.
And obviously you're going to want to actually take some time with writing these emails here. I'm just doing this For example purposes, we'll go ahead and click on Done Editing, and it will take us back to our workflow. And now that we have email number one, we're going to want to select a delay, probably one day later, and we'll send our second email. So we'll just click on again, we'll do email number two, give it a nice juicy title, and then we'll click on Save, and we'll create another delay. So typically what we're going to do is we're going to send anywhere from 5 to 7 emails in this sequence. So we'll go ahead and click on select wait another day again, and then add email number three. And you'd go through this process for all of the emails in your initial sequence. And then after the first 5 to 7 emails, typically what you're going to do is that will be the end of the sequence. The sequence will be over. They'll have gotten their lead magnet. Hopefully you've made some sort of paid offer, whether it's your own service, your own product, or an affiliate in the last 2 to 3 emails in the sequence. And then because you made sure that you added them to everyone, they can start getting your weekly or monthly email newsletter or broadcasts. So we'll go ahead and get out of this automation list because we have our landing page set up. We made sure that we created our automation that sends emails out. I should note here that we probably do want to make sure that you turn it on so that it's actually active. And that is really all there is to it, to creating your landing page and then actually putting together some back-end automation. Now, if you're still watching, enjoying this video, go ahead and hit that like button. What I want to do is actually come back to something that's a little bit of a bonus when it comes to putting together your landing page, and that's actually your success page. So we glossed over this, but we do want to be taking advantage of the attention that we've gotten from someone who's just entered our email list. So if we go ahead and click on edit here, this is something bonus you can do. You don't have to do it right off the bat. And that is adding something to your success page, telling people what to do next. So I'm going to come up here to actions, remove blocks, and type in remove, nice and big. Remove everything. Again, I'm just going to do a headline. And then this time you can either do an image here. Come on. There, we'll either put an image, or if you want to make some sort of paid offer, or you want to try and offer some sort of affiliate offer, then you can go ahead and put a video. So you can drop in a short sales video here if you want someone to take action, and then use the button element to have them click through to another page. And so in this particular instance, I don't really have another offer to make. So I'm just going to say, thank you, it's on the way. I'll come over here to settings. I'll just change our font color to the orange again and make sure that it's medium. Oh, and make sure that it's actually centered too. And then for our image, I'll actually come into our images here and just select the same image that I had on the landing page to let them know, yes, their PDF is in fact on the way. That image is way too big. So let's come over here to settings. Let's make it medium and then bring it down so it's not as large. And then the only other thing that I would recommend doing here is just putting some sort of quick text that lets them know the actual email address that they should look for, because sometimes our messages might go into folders or spam that we don't want them to. So we want to make it very easy for people to find us. Add some quick text here, check your email from, and then go ahead and put your domain in, and that's all you need to do. If you want to add social links, or maybe you have a piece of content you want them to engage with, you can go ahead and drop that in here as well. I'm just going to delete these other elements because we don't actually have a sales message here, and also remove the button. And again, this is a bonus thing you can do. You don't necessarily have to get that fancy or worry about, oh no, I have to come up with another offer or another thing for someone to do right after they've entered their name and email. So thank you so much for watching. I sincerely hope you got some value out of this video. And most importantly, you're ready to go to start growing your email list on the path to 5,000 email subscribers and hopefully a lot more. So check out those links in the description to MailerLite, along with some other helpful videos to help you get up and running with this process as quickly as possible. Hit that like button, subscribe for more deep dive marketing tutorials just like this one. And until the next, keep building the business you love.